Hello everyone and welcome to CAD CAM CE tutorials. This is the fourth part in the series of hand wash dispenser assembly, and in this video we are going to create three components, that is the tube, spring stem and the cover. So let's begin it. Let us first close it and we'll go for a file, create a new part and OK. Now first we'll make background plain white. Select here plain white. Now to create the tube, we are mainly going to use the swept boss feature. And to use swept boss feature, we need two sketches, one for the guiding curve and the second for the cross section. So first we'll sketch the guiding curve, and for that we'll go for sketch. And we'll select here front plane for the sketching plane. Now first we'll sketch one line, that vertical line over here, like this. After creating the vertical line, we'll go for the 3-point arc and we'll create one arc like this. Now after sketching both the entities, we'll select here this line, press Ctrl and select here this arc. For both these entities, we'll select here tangent and click on OK. After that, we'll go for the dimensions. So we'll select here smart dimension. This length is of 30 mm. And the distance between the endpoints of the arc is of 50 mm. Enter here 50. Now we have to specify the radius for this arc. So the radius is of 600 mm. Enter here 600. Now you can see that the sketch is fully defined. So we'll exit the smart dimension and we'll exit the sketch. Now after creating the guiding curve, we have to create the cross section for the tubes, that is the concentric circles. And for that we'll go for the sketch and we'll select here top plane as a sketching plane and we'll go for the normal view. Now here we are going to create two concentric circles. So we'll select here circle and we'll create two concentric circles like this. Okay. Now we'll go for the smart dimension. The bigger circle is of diameter 6 mm. Enter here 6 mm. And the smaller one is of diameter 5 mm. Enter here 5. Now the sketch is fully defined, so we'll exit the smart dimension and we'll exit the sketch. Now after getting both the sketches, one for the guiding curve, second for the cross section, we'll go for the features and select swept boss feature. Now first we have to select the sketch for the cross section, so that is the sketch 2, and here we have to select the sketch for the path or the guiding curve, that is the sketch 1. Once you select both the sketches, you can see the preview of the tube that is going to be created and click on OK. Now this is the seventh part, that is the tube, and now we will save it. Before we are going to save, we will apply the appearance, and for that we will select here part, we will go for the appearance. In the appearance we will select here plastic, in the plastic we will select here clear plastic, and in the clear plastic we will select here the polycarbonate plastic. Now we'll save it. So we'll go for the save as and we'll name it as a tube. Okay. Now we'll go for the next component, and that is the spring stem. So let us first close it. We'll go for file, create a new part and OK. Now first we'll make background plain white. Now to create the spring stem, we are going to use the revolve boss feature, and for that let us first create one sketch. So we'll go for the sketch and we'll select here front plane as a sketching plane. Now first we'll insert one vertical center line. So we'll go for the center line, create one vertical center line like this. After inserting a center line, we'll create one rough sketch using the lines. So we'll select here line and we'll create one sketch like this. Now after creating this sketch, we are applying the dimensions to the different entities, and for that we'll go for the smart dimension. Now the distance of this vertical line from the center line is of 5 mm. Enter here 5. The distance of this vertical line from the center line is of 6 mm. Enter here 6. Now the distance of this vertical line from the center line is of 2.5. And the distance of this vertical line from the center line, that is of 4.5. Now the length of this line is of 5 mm. So we'll enter here 5. And the length of this line is of 6 mm. Enter here 6. Now we have to specify the overall length. So we'll select here this point. Select here this point. And the overall length is of 30 mm. Enter here 30. Now after specifying all these dimensions, we'll exit the smart dimension. Now we'll select here the origin, press Ctrl and select here this point. For both this point, we'll go for the horizontal as a constant. And click on OK. Now you can see that the entire sketch is fully defined. So we'll exit the sketch. We'll go for the features and select revolve boss feature and click on OK. Now our part is completed and we'll go for the appearance. So we'll select here entire part. We'll go for the appearance. In the appearance, we'll go for the plastic, medium gloss plastic, and we'll select here this blue color that is over here. And now we'll save it. So we'll go for the save as and we'll name it as a spring stem. And click on OK. Now we are going to create the last component of the assembly, and that is the cover. Now before that, let us first close it. And we'll go for File, select here Part, and OK. Now let us select here Background Plain White. Now to create the cover, first we'll go for the sketch. And we select a top plane as a sketching plane. Here we'll draw one circle with a diameter of 23 mm. So we'll create one circle. Go for the smart dimension. Enter diameter as 23 mm. After creating this circle, we'll exit the smart dimension. And we'll exit the sketch. Now we have to extrude it for 18 mm. So we'll go for the features. Select here extrude boss feature. Now here depth is of 18 mm, so we'll enter here 18 and click on OK. Now after creating this boss extrude feature, we have to give here fillet, and for that we'll select here fillet and enter here fillet radius as 0.5 mm, and then we'll select here this edge and OK. Now for the cover, we need to create a hollow structure, and for that we'll use the shell feature. To invoke the shell feature, we'll select here the shell. The shell thickness is of 1 mm, so we'll enter here 1 mm. And then we'll select here this face, because we want to make it hollow from the below side. Click on OK. Now after creating this shell, we have to remove some portion from this top portion. And for that, we'll go for the sketch. Then we'll select here this face and make it here normal. Now here we'll create one circle with a diameter of 12 mm, and for that we'll go for the circle and create one circle like this. Then we'll go for the smart dimension and enter diameter as a 12 mm. Now after creating this circle, we'll exit the smart dimension and we'll exit the sketch. After that we'll go for the features and select extrude cut feature, and from here we'll select through all. And OK. Now after creating this hollow structure, we need to add some material over here, and for that we'll go for the sketch, and then we'll select here this lower face as a sketching plane, and we'll go for the normal. Now first we'll select here this outer edge, right click, and select here convert entities. After creating this entity, we'll go for the offset entities. Now for the offset distance, we'll enter here 0.18 mm as offset distance. Then we'll select here this circle and click on OK. Now after creating these two concentric circles, we'll exit the sketch. We'll go for the features and select extrude boss feature. Now first we need to reverse the direction. So we'll select here reverse the direction And for the depth, we'll enter here 1 mm as a depth and click on OK. Now, after creating this hollow structure, we need to add the threads. And for that, let us first go for the reference geometry. Select here plane. Now, we'll create one plane that is at a distance of 8 mm from the bottom side. So, for the reference, we'll select here this bottom face. For the distance, we'll enter here 8 mm as a distance. And we need to create plane on the top side of the face. And for that, we'll select here flip offset. Click on OK. After creating this plane, we need to create the circle that is for the helix. And for that, we'll go for the sketch. We'll select here this plane as a sketching plane. And we'll go for the normal view. Now, to create the circle, left click on this inner edge. Then right click and select here convert entities. After converting into entity, we'll exit the sketch. Now, after creating this circle, we'll go for the features. Select here curves and select here helix and spiral. Now, first we need to reverse the direction of the spiral. So, we'll select here reverse the direction. From here, we'll select pitch and revolution to define the helix. Now, in our case, the pitch is of 5 mm, so we'll enter here 5 mm. And here, the revolution is 1.5 revolution. Enter here 1.5. And for the start angle, we'll enter here 0 as a start angle. And click on OK. Now, after creating the helix, that is the guiding curve for the threads, we need to create the cross section for the threads. And for that, we need to create one sketch that is passing through this endpoint of the helix. So, as we know that the starting angle is 0, and here this endpoint is passing through the right plane. So, for the sketching of the cross section of the threads, we'll go for the sketch, and we'll select here right plane as a sketching plane, and we'll go for the normal view. Now, here first we'll create one triangle, and for that we'll go for the polygons. Now, we'll enter here 3 as a number of sides. And we'll create one triangle like this. Now, after creating this triangle, we'll select here this center point. Press Ctrl and select here this helix. For both of these, we'll select here pi s as a constraint. And click on OK. Now, after creating this triangle, we'll go for the dimensioning. And for that, we'll select here smart dimension. Now, the height of the triangle is of 1 mm. So, we'll enter here 1 mm. Now, after specifying the height, we have to create here fillet, and for that we'll exit the smart dimension. We'll go for the sketch fillet, and here enter 0.2 as radius of the fillet, and then we'll select here this apex, and OK. Now, this is the cross section of the threads, so we'll exit the sketch. After creating the cross section as well as the guiding curve, we'll go for the features, and we'll select here swept boss feature. Now, this is the cross section that we have created, and for the guiding curve, we'll select here this helix. After selecting both the sketches, you can see the preview of the threads and can click on OK. So, this is the last component of the assembly, that is the cover. Now, we'll right click on this plane and we'll select here hide. Now, after creating these, we'll go for the appearance, and for that, we'll select here entire part. We'll go for the appearance. And we'll select here this red color. Now we'll save it. So we'll go for the save as. And we'll name it as a cover. And click on OK.